Okay, today I'm going to explain one end-to-end procedure for the account determination, MMFI integration. Okay. Let me create one complete scenario for that. Okay. I'll keep a notepad. Okay, first I'll create a material. Okay, requirement from the client is they want to get customized one material type. Just imagine the scenario, because for the standard material type already the valuation class and GL account, everything will be copied from the golden client. So not required to do any customization for the account determination. But in case they are looking for new requirement where they want to customize material type, then second they are looking for new valuation class. Okay, maybe I'll take 3800. Okay, this is ROH valuation class, ZROH. Then third thing is that the price control you have to check. Then fourth is like OBI settings. Okay, then check GL accounts. Okay, so while doing this process we are going to work on valuation grouping code, then valuation modifier and all. It's a next level understanding. First, I will explain basic process today in part one. Then tomorrow I will talk about the next level of understanding. Okay. Let's go in a slow phase so you'll understand the process completely. Okay. I'll take not ZROH. ZROH will be already there in the system. Let me take ZHRO. This is the new material type I'm going to configure. Then this is the valuation class I'm going to define. Then respective valuation account reference category, everything I'm going to modify according to this material type. Okay. The cleanup activity is not at done, Pritham, right? For the extra material type.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah, please. Yeah. Check once today. Possible to do that?
I will do it. Yeah.
For example, if I go and create any material through a material type, right? Let me show an example. ZRHO or any some other ZROH. Okay, this is a raw material already customized. I don't want to do again. Okay, we'll take this ZORH. This is the new customized material type which we have created before. Okay, now if I create material for this type, material type, okay, so I want to see the accounting view. Okay, go to this view, and JP01 can take a metal rod each. In the accounting view, so here if you go to valuation class, you can see all the standard which is there for ROH. We are able to see it, right? But now the requirement is that for this material type ZORH, right, they want to have different valuation class, which is 3800. Okay, 3800 is not available here. It's not available. Okay, how I can handle this scenario or requirement? Okay, I'll go to screen. Okay, this is now reading. So I'll just go to material type, and I will maintain the account reference categories different for the GORH. So that will we can go and create valuation class, and we can have different valuation class for that material type. In case I am not going to change the account reference query using the same account reference query, then I'm linking, then the same GL account drop down, the new valuation class will be showing in the drop down. So again, user will get confused what and all which they have to select. If there are many are there, they'll get confused. If I keep only one valuation class for this particular material type, then I have to manage through the account reference category. If I change from 0001 to some other account reference category, then again in that reference category other valuation class also will be there. So how to keep single valuation class for this particular material type ZORH, that I have to search any whichever account reference category which is there in the system should not have any other valuation classes. Okay, so I have to check once, then I will go and handle that in the system. Okay, it's taking more time to load this OMS2, so then definitely we have to clean up today without fail. Okay, let me explain a little about account posting. BSX is inventory posting, where we'll see debit means plus when you receive the goods, and the WRX is for GRIR clearance. Which is credit means we have to clear that value to vendor. This is during the GR time. Okay, then for the same scenario, if you are going to create invoice and post, then you'll have KBS, which is vendor clearance, vendor debit. I think vendor credit will be minus. And WRX will be a plus here. GRIR clearance plus credit debit. Okay, this is the process for GR and IR, like GR and invoice time, how exactly the account will get hit. Okay, that I'm going to show now. So here I'm going to check the ZORH metal type. I'll go inside here. Okay, now it is showing account reference category is 0001. Okay, there are many account reference categories there in the system, right? So I can define new account reference category also, like a Z123 or something new I am going to create now, or I can create ZORH only. Okay, so just to, or ZROH, something I'm going to try here. I'm going to enter ZROH. It is saying entry ZROH does not exist in T025K. It is clearly showing that whatever we have created in the created account reference category, which will get stored in T0125K. So this is a table. If data is not there in the table, it will not allow you to enter that, because it is not possible to fetch the data from that table. Okay, how to check that? Go to SC16N. This is all like consultant level knowledge you should have. Okay, which table, where, how it will get stored? T0125K. If I enter T025K, then it's a account reference category table. If I execute here, you're able to see that all the ACR entry in this table. Now, if I create new account reference category, there are 201 entries are there that it will show in the screen. Okay, I'll go back. I'll go to SPR screen, then I'll create new account reference category. Then I'll come back. I'll change this in this screen. Okay. Go to SAP reference IMG. So I will show the transaction code also, particular path and transaction. Let me go to metal management, valuation and account assignment. Under this valuation and account assignment, I have to search for determination, account determination, account determination without wizard. Then here you can see the transaction. So define valuation control is OMWM, and group together valuation area is OMWD. Then define valuation class is OMSK. Then define account grouping for movement types OMWN. And then configure automatic posting, it's OMWB. But if you go to OBYC, then yeah, that main screen can be viewed. Now I'm going to define valuation classes, where I'm going to create account category reference, ACR. Okay, here I'm going to do new entry, ZORH, account reference category. The new for customized material type ZORH. I'll give the for custom ZORH. Okay, then I'm saving it. So ZORH entry is done. If I go back to a table, if I search for ZORH, here see now 202 entry is there. I can able to see that ZORH, which is custom material type ZORH, is got maintained in the table level. Okay, now I'll go back to a screen where OMS2 screen is there. I'm going to replace, I'll go back, I'll check whether it is there in this drop down. Here I'll search. Here one option is there always, you can search. When you go to drop down option, one small triangle shaped down arrow is there. So just search here, ZORH. Okay, the custom material type ZORH is coming here. Okay, then you select this. Okay, now save this for ZORH. Save it. Okay, now if I go to MM01, just testing purpose for this material type ZORH, I will not go for all the views. I will go only for the accounting view, just for testing purpose. Okay, when I go to accounting view, if I select this valuation class, see, you can see no valuation found. You might have got this kind of problem when you update the account reference category in the material type, but there is no linkage between account reference category and valuation class and material type. Once you do that setting in the backend, then you are able to see the new valuation class in this drop down. Okay, let's test after doing the configuration. I'll go back to the screen where ACR is done. Now I'll come back and create valuation class. Okay, here I'm going to create a valuation class, new entry. 3800 is my valuation class. And I'm going to enter the ZORH account reference category. Enter. Okay, it is coming ZORH description here. And I should enter metal type here, valuation class here. Custom ValCL. Okay, for ZROH. I'm just entering the description. Okay, I'm just saving it. Again, I'll go to MM01 and I'll test it. I'll choose only accounting view here. Okay, here if you see, valuation class is there. Simple. How it is coming, I'll explain here again. Here I maintain valuation class, account reference category is done. Is the linkage between ACR and valuation class. Next, I have already maintained the OMS to entry where material type and ACR is handled. In case, if I don't maintain that, if I don't maintain here as URH, then definitely, example, I'll do it 0001. I'll just change this and save this. Okay, 0001 I entered. Then if I go back to a screen, front end, MM01, I select a accounting view. Here if I enter, see, it is showing this many valuation classes because 0001 I entered. Okay, but when I change that to a ZORH, even I can go to in the backend SPRO screen where I am changing the material class and everything, right? Let me go there. Here I'll check for the material type. See, if I try to maintain here, it is showing user 72 is locked. Means I'm in the screen, okay, where I'm not able to maintain. Okay, see, example, I'll try here. See, it is not allowing to maintain. I'll go back completely here. Then I'll try for here. Material type and account reference category linkage. I'll search here ZORH. Okay, ZORH is showing as 0001 because in the OMS2 I have maintained 0001. Now I'm going to change this as ZORH as a new custom ACR. Once I maintain this in the screen, then if I go to MM01, let me open new screen here. Okay, I'll go to MM01. Now I'll try for the valuation class. Okay, so here it is default. Why? Because only one valuation class is there, it is picking up automatically. Or you can go and select this like this. Okay, like this, you can define a valuation class for the particular material type if business is looking for a single valuation class for that. How you can maintain multiple? If they ask two valuation classes for this particular material types, simple. You should go to valuation class, do new entry, make 3900 here, ACR, enter. Okay, salary it is there, same key. Let me try with the 4000. 4000 is there. 4100. Yeah, 4100 is not there. Okay, I'm going with custom ZRH 2, or maybe some other meaning will be there. In the business, they will come up with different valuation class for different GL account to hit. That's it, right? So that you can differentiate. One material type may have multiple valuation classes, but while choosing in the material master, you can choose the respective valuation class that will get hit with for that GL account. Okay, if anyone ask in the interview, is it possible to handle two valuation class for single material? No, you cannot maintain two valuation class in the single material. Only one option is there in the accounting view. You can maintain one valuation class, but later you can modify, okay, for that valuation class with a general modifier, and you can handle multiple GL accounts with that general modifier. That is one option is there. Again, one question will be there. Is that possible to handle multiple GL account for a material type? Yes. If you talk about material type, you can handle multiple valuation classes. Example, you would have seen ROH always will have multiple. Someone is customized also. Now for the ZRH, if I want to have a multiple valuation class, then I can have multiple valuation classes in the system. When creating material, you are going to differentiate. Example, ZRH is a material type. I can handle raw material of mechanical goods, electronic goods, or oil items, whatever, which is raw material only. Under that raw material, I can group it. Okay, for this mechanical goods, I am going to handle, then I should get 3,800 as the valuation class. If I'm handling electronic goods, then 4,100 will be my valuation class. Like that, I can select different valuation class based on the material which you're going to create. Material type will be single, but the group of metal you are going to purchase is different. Then you can decide. Okay, example, I'll make it. This is for electronic goods. Okay, not to confuse people, this electronic goods under this. Okay, save it. And for the 3,800, I'll make it mechanical goods. This is our mechanical goods. Yeah, I'll create two material. One is mechanical goods, means I'll take metal rod, I'm going to purchase. Another electronic or electrical goods, which is resistor, capacitor, something I'm going to purchase, like that. Okay, so then I'll have a different valuation class for each metal which I'm going to purchase with the metal type ZRH. Okay, now if I go to MM01, and if I try to create a material, see here, so I have two valuation class, which is one is for mechanical goods, one is for electronic goods. Now I'm going to purchase a mechanical goods metal rod, and price of that material is like 50 INR for each piece. Okay, then it's asking for a base unit of measurement. Done. I'm going to save this. Material got created. Now I can extend that material for different views, whichever is required for the purchasing purpose, right? I'm adding this material and I'm going to extend the required fields. Account is already done, and I'll extend other fields for the JP01. I'll quickly move with the screen where I can choose material group also, which is belong to mechanics. Okay, I'll press enter, which is important fields. I will just add here and I'll save it. Okay, metal got extended. This is one material where we are focusing on one valuation class. Okay, so valuation class which we selected is 3,800. Next, I am going to create a material. Which is capacitor. Okay, it's electronics. Okay, Here you can change the group also. Mechanical groups handled by JS3 and electronic group handled by some other department. If I search JS star, I can find JS9, JSG, right? So I can take Durga. Now Durga, who is handling electronic parts. Here I'll come to accounting view. Here I'm going to change the valuation class to 4100. The price of this capacitor is 10. Okay, save it. Okay, so I got two material got created here. One is mechanical, one is electronics, right? So this is 4100 valuation class. Now how system will determine the account automatically? That is our learning for the day, right? Let me go to ME21N and I'll try to raise the order for this material first. Okay, JP10, JS3, I think. Steel products and JS07. And I'm going to take one. Let me take one only, one purchasing. Because one is, you will find the value and all very clearly. If I go with multiple quantity, then you're not able to understand the value and all. Let it be one each. Okay, I'll search for the material. For this material, I don't have any vendors. Okay, let me get any vendor which is for JP10. Okay, it is not there. I'll remove this. I'll try to get the material from this. So can you mute yourself, please? Someone unmuted yourself. Okay, see, there is no info record, which is in the system. Automatically, it is not picking up the value. So I'll pick the value from the metal master. Example, this material have a accounting value of 50. I just pick from the metal master manually. Okay, everything is good. I'm going to save this PO. Okay, now thing is that while receiving the goods, whether system will allow us to post? No, because automatic account determination is not yet done for this valuation class, right? Material document will be it'll allow while we are checking the, when we check the GR time, it'll work. Example, if I go and check this, okay, it'll show document is okay. Okay, location I'm going to enter. Here, if I check, it'll show document is okay. But the problem is, okay, the location is not extended. That I'll do it quickly. Go to material. See, there's no location. I'll just copy this. MM01 into this material, extend the location, JP01 and JS01. I'm just extending and save it. Now I'll go to MyGo, enter this PO. Quantity, material, everything is fine. Adding the store location. Now if I check this item, okay. The system says document is okay because material document posting level is good. Everything is fine. But accounting side, it is not good. If I try to post here, okay, then it will show an error, right? BSX, this blank, two blanks will be there. 3800 is not exist. So what and all things you should handle here? Let me maximize this. Okay, so here system only says, if you go to this question mark, only says these are not handled properly. Chart of account, transaction event key, valuation grouping code, account grouping code, and valuation class. This is not handled properly. Now, how to handle these things in the system? Already you guys know how to fix it. The same way I'm going to OBYC is the setting where I can do this entry. BSX INT is my chart of account for that company code. And here, see, you can see multiple valuation class are there. And GL account. In case you have a new GL account, okay, 3000, this 30011 is your new GL account. Need to hit, you are looking for this to be hit during the GR tab. Then you are going to copy this line and adding as a Z, 3800 is your valuation class. This account is entered. So now BSX is clear. Okay, this is there. We have entered this GL account. In case in real time, your GL account is different for the inventory posting for this particular valuation class, then definitely you are reaching out to finance consultant what GL account need to be selected. If it is not there, need to create GL account through FS00 transaction. Okay, that is the process to be followed. Now I entered GL account here. Now I'll go back to screen MIGO. So next entry, what you can imagine which will be the error. If there is a different GL account, sorry, valuation class to be maintained for the GR error clearance, that also you can check in the backend. Go to OBYC. And here, next entry is for what? After BSX, WRX, GR error clearance. Here, you can see for the WRX, you have both options. One, they have maintained a straight valuation class with GL account. You can, if you don't have 3800 here, definitely it will show an error, throw an error. Another entry is there. Example, if you see 0001 will have one GL account. Okay. Then 0001 have a different here modifier is there, right? 0001 1005 will have a different GL account like that. This is called valuation modifier, where you are going to maintain this in the backend, where you are grouping it. You are going to maintain the valuation grouping code in the backend. Then that you can assign here. But when I click here, system cannot display possible entries here. You cannot display here. But while doing any entry, example, if I copy something this line, let me do a entry for 3800. Let me first do the GR posting, then you'll find the error. Then I'll go and fix it. Item okay, check. Looking for location. I'll enter the location, check it, and I'll try to post it. See, while posting, GL account, see, GL account 30011, it does not exist in company code GS07. See, if there is no GL account, then that also problem. We cannot use that GL account for the posting purpose. Okay, I will use the standard GL account, which is maintained for 1000, which we copied. We cannot use other GL account until unless it is not maintained for the GS07 company code. Okay, I'll go to BSX. Here I'll go and maintain. This is already available in the system, I know. Okay, enter. Save it. Okay, here I'll check it. So that shows okay. When I go to post option, it will show WRX is not possible. This is second error. Okay, now I'm going to fix this in the system in OBYC setting. So without understanding why all these things to be done, some people, like few people, will go and do that setting in OBYC. That is not right. Understand the concept. Why I have to do this BSX entry? Why I have to do this WRX before posting the details? These two are mandatory to be maintained in the system. So I'll copy this 3000 entry and I go for 3800. So here just learning purpose we are using GL account is same, because again creating new GL account all data will be inconsistent sometime, because FICO knowledge we will not have much knowledge how to fix it. Okay, even something we create new GL account, it is possible new GL account you can create and you can assign here, that will get hit, but learning time it's not required. So you should understand why, how this valuation class is entered and which GL account is going to hit. That's enough. Because if you will ask, okay, 3000 also will have GL account, 3800 also have same GL account. Here we are just using same because just learning purpose. In real time, we can just change this GL account, then that GL account will hit during the GR time. That's it. Okay. Save this and go to here, screen, check, and try to post. Now system should allow you to post the GR because BSX and WRX both entered with the valuation class 3800. Okay, then you are able to see the material document here. If I go and display the material document in the screen, if you go to document info and FI document, accounting document, then you are able to see the BSX and WRX GL account. You would have seen this. We have maintained 30010 for the BSX, and WRX we have entered 417000, and this 89 is like a debit account for the inventory posting. If you search here, 89 stock inward movement 89. If you see 96, it's a credit account. See GRIR credit. It's very clear. 89 and 96 is different posting keys. Okay. And price also, the 50s INR is a one number we have received. 50 is the value of that material which is debited in our account. It's positive for us. Then this is pending to clear the value to the vendor. Then you think, okay, what is the profit for us? We have purchased a metal rod from the vendor with this much of cost, but you do something process on that metal rod and then you sell it for more value, then that will be the profit. How much you bargain with the vendor to get the material, then you will get more profit from the business. That's it, right? It's a normal business, whichever, however you are doing in a daily basis, if you're doing business. Okay, that's it for the one account which we have learned. Now, if you want to see 4100, then this is for you. You just create a material, already material is created with 4100. Then if you try to create a PO, then do the GR, then you will get an error saying that INT BSX with two blank, and then 4100 not possible like that. It will come like that. Okay, so like that you can learn by creating a new material type, then valuation class, then respective account reference category to be maintained for that, then only you can able to see that in the Metal Master where you can select the particular valuation class. This is for moving average price. Okay, tomorrow I will show it for standard price. Okay, standard price, how the account will hit. If I purchase with a different value, there will be a BSX, WRX. If it is a value, is both value is same. Purchase value and Metal Master price is both same. Then only BSX and WRX will hit. In case price is difference, BSX, WRX, and PRD. Okay. So maybe this one I can show tomorrow also. Another round of transaction, I will show it. How to if valuation class different, then this process is same. Just you have to manage the BSX and WRX value for that 4100. Then you can easily post it. Okay, but for the standard price, I will show it tomorrow. How to handle with the same price with different price? How the GL account will hit? What is PRD? And all I will explain in detail. Okay, then even I will explain GBB. How to use general modifier. Yeah, we'll update these things tomorrow. If we have multiple general modifier, how we can use it? Or PRD also we have a general modifier. We have a for KON also we'll have a general modifier. And even we have done for subcontracting. I explained very neatly in the subcontracting process how the GL account will hit and what are the transaction event key. Consignment I will brief it tomorrow. Okay, how this will trigger when you are going to settle the value, because GR time will not find any accounting entries. Okay, no accounting entry during the GR time, but after consumption when you settle the value, then after MRKO you'll find the accounting documents. There I'll show you the GL account, whatever is going to hit consumption part and all, right? I'll show it clearly. Okay, then apart from that, standard I have covered, and consignment I'm going to show, subcontracting is done. Then in case of STO and all, it is not yet covered. Intra STO and inter STO, this process is not yet started. Once I cover this intra and inter STO, that time only I will explain the accounting entries, where exactly account entries will happen, whether it is in a PGA or PGR. Okay, or PGR, that I'm going to explain. And even in 301 movement type, I have explained BSX will happen minus in the issuing plant and plus in the receiving plant during the 301 movement type only, immediately. There's no account entry with the separately, both will trigger during the 301 movement type only. Receiving plant, sorry. If you do 303 and 305, here you'll find accounting documents. But here in 305, you'll not find any accounting documents. No accounting. 311, no accounting documents. For 541, no accounting documents. Okay, 101K. No accounting document. Okay, then try for next, tomorrow we'll try for 501 and 561. How the system will behave. This is for tomorrow. Okay, where we'll look for GBB. This is other option. We are not going to refer any order. Here we are doing initial entry for the stock. During the implementation time, we do the initial entry of the stock to the plant and all through 561 uploading part. Okay, let's cover these all things tomorrow. I'll just brief it. And even I'll show one scenario where I'm doing 501, 561, how the GL account will hit, all that we can discuss, and even general modifier, how we can use it accordingly, we'll discuss tomorrow. Okay, thank you. Okay, any questions do you have in this today's session?
Nothing as of now, operation. Maybe when we do hands on, it will occur.
Yeah, watch it again and do it without fail. Because one scenario, if you do whatever I have shown, that is enough to understand major things. Okay, even if you get any job, yeah, in your company or in an organization to do this kind of work, okay, you'll not hesitate to jump and do it. Okay, and even in the interview time, if you explain very clearly about the steps and how to handle all this process, right? So then they will think, okay, you have a good knowledge to handle the process. If you have good knowledge, then if any new requirement come up, right, then they are not required to again educate you and all this, right? You directly you take up and you will just finish it. That's why they will expect little more knowledge on MMFI integration. Karthik, are you good with this now? Because you have little confusion, right? How to handle?
Yeah, yeah. I am just clear, Prashant. Now yeah. It's okay. Yeah. I can having some build more confidence on attending this type of questions in the interviews.
Exactly. Yeah. Tomorrow I will take up more in-depth knowledge on a general modifier, evaluation accounting group, okay, code. That and all things I am going to handle as per my experience. Beyond that, if something is there, definitely you can explore and look from others also. There are many are there in outside who are consulting more than 15 years, 20 years and all, right? If someone you find, okay, so then you just talk to them. I learned all this process, okay? And then apart from this, what kind of knowledge I should have or I should gain? So is it possible to handle it in an IDA system, in a practice system? Then help me. So you just explore with them. If you're learning new things, apart from whatever I have guided you, then even you just come back and explain me. I am ready to learn. Okay, I am always open to learn new things along with existing the knowledge. Okay. Now, Shivan, you can check with your colleagues or friends who have worked on account determination in a real time. Many people are not will not have a much exposure because this process we will do in the implementation time only majorly. After that, we'll have a support work. Okay. If any new valuation class is introduced in the business or any new material type is introduced, then only we'll get the work like this. Or else if they're using for a long time same process without changing anything, if you're supporting for last 3 years or 4 years, definitely you will not get this kind of work for you, work in the system. Okay, I hope you're clear now.
Yes, yes, Prashant.
Okay.
Prashant, for the subcontracting stock, right? I think the transaction code is MBLB. I think yesterday you asked me, right?
Whether okay.
I can check it like that.
Thank you, Karthik, for sharing that details. MBLB, right? MBLB.
Yes, MBLB.
Just to monitor the stock, right?
Stocks in subcontracting stocks available in the subcontracting. What is the stock, existing stock available in subcontracting vendor?
Okay, let me check once the transaction. MBLB. Okay, yeah. Stocks at subcontract. If I enter this vendor number, if any stocks is available in stock, then it will show. If I don't enter here, just I enter any material plant number, ISBL. Anything is there, it will show. Anyone have created any stocks, then I can search here. Example 1000. I'll try with 1000 plant. Someone already given stock to a vendor, subcontractor. It will show all the list of data in this transaction, stocks at transfer subcontractor. See, when I enter only 1000, it took long time to extract because a lot of material someone practiced. 1000 is like a standard plant, right? Many are using it and they're just testing it, and you can see a lot of material here with the vendor. The stock is available in the vendor. Yeah, this is a monitoring T code that the business user can use, MBLB, and they can monitor it. Thanks, Karthik.
Prashant, for the material stored in location extension, directly we can use it to decode MMSE, right?
Yes. MMSE is for mass transfer, mass update. Example, if you go to MMSE, which is for mass. Example, if I enter MMSE for the material. Now see, I got material of this, okay, which is 3048. I'll copy this. I'll go to MMSE, plant is JP01. Then here I can add multiple stored location. Okay, transaction control error is there. I don't know why. I'll try for 47, this material. One second, MMSE. Some problem is there in this. Second, I'll try with again MMSC list all existing stored location. Okay, list extendable stored locations only. Now some problem is there in the system. Normally if you go to MMSC, if you enter the material and plant, when you go for next screen, there you can see multiple entries, table kind structure. There you can, if you are extending 20 stored location, 30 stored location, then you can use MMSC. If you are extending only one location, then you can go to MM01 and you can extend it. I'm just extending only JP01 with the JS01 stored location, just for testing purpose. But if I extend all 10 to 20 stored location, I'll come to the screen as a user, then I'll extend for the all the stored location. That's a difference, okay?
Okay.
So try with your another server, MMSC will work, I think. In this server, some issue is there. Transaction controller is there. I don't know how it is coming. Have you tried in your server, Karthik?
Yeah, it's working.
It's working, okay. You just demonstrate one, take one material, okay, demonstrate how to handle mass extension of stored location, record a session, and send us. We will place it in our share folder.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Explain it very neatly, which scenario will get this and how you do this and how the system will behave and how the result will be there. Once you does that work in MMSC and show all the Metal Master stored location extended in which transaction. How you will view one metal have these many locations?
Like in the same transaction, you can able to see, right? The, if the list first option, if I'm selecting the first option,
correct.
Then I can able to list all the materials.
Yeah, that is
the radio button. Locations available. Yes.
Yeah, radio button. You just explore it and explain in a proper way how to view, how to extend. There are two radio buttons. Okay. You have to clearly explain. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Fine then. Okay. Fine then. We'll catch up tomorrow for the part two. Let's even I am going to prepare some data for general modifier action process. How I can use GBB account and how I can use BSA or VBR, VBO, all that are there, right? I will just research and I'll do it and I'll come back. Okay. Good day then. Take care.